Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rakah Kadash. Double honor to the apostles and elders, GMS, who rule well, teach well, being great example to his younger brothers, and peace and blessings. And salutations to you, hopeful lake out there, pushing this word in truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, pushing to get up out of here. Shalom to the hopeful lake, the believers, the listeners who have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. All right, just want to do a quick, news report, all right, dealing with, what's going on in Turkey. You know, also, there's an attack, all right, on ownership, all right, because at the end of the day, these elites have an agenda, and their agenda is complete control, all right. They want more control, everything that they're doing, all right, and the pitch is that it's convenience, but it's control, all right. Everything is based on control. You have the Amazon Go store, all right, which is what it, the pitch is convenience, but it's based on control, man, which we'll get into it, in another video, all right. But they're pushing convenience, all right, in return for them having more control, all right, over each individual. Now, as you see in America, right before I did this lesson, I seen a brother, the brother Page, Bakwar Moth, very diligent brother, subscribe to their brother channel, Bakwar Space Moth, all right, and be edified, history and news, brother be going in, but I was seeing them saying how, New York to fully reopen, all right, July the 1st, all right, so New York is preparing to open. What do you have in Turkey? All right, it says, this is from Al Jazeera, and it says, Turkey prepares for full lockdown amid rising, all right, crown royal numbers. It says, Turkey will enforce a nationwide lockdown from Thursday until May 17th to fight a surging third wave, all right, of infections. You see, it says the measures are set to be enforced from 7 p.m., all right, appear to be designed to avoid another spike approximately, all right, the time of traditional family gatherings and celebrations that take place when the Muslim holy month of Ramadan, all right, Ramadan, ends in mid-May, so as America, is opening up, all right, they're locking down, other countries, man, and the elites, all right, are spreading a lot of confusion, with their agenda, man. You don't know what to believe, how to move, mask on, mask off, you don't know what to do, man. If you're waiting to get your instructions from this man's media, and his, his pharmaceutical, if you're waiting, to get instruction from his so-called experts, I leave it at that, because you gotta be sensitive how you move on here, all right. But if you're waiting to get information from his experts, you'll be all over the place, man, and that's how he's able to accomplish, all right, so much wickedness, all right, because he has the masses confused, man. But the water, for Yahweh Bashim Awashai, all right, through Yahweh Shai, that we walk in the light and we can see straight through this man's agenda. Now, when you go to Isaiah, all right, 10:1, it says, woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees and that write grievousness which they have prescribed. Yeah, see, this man is ruling the earth, all right, in a very grievous way. These are unrighteous decrees. People's lives are being destroyed based on false, pretense. You see, and the word grievousness, all right, goes into toil, trouble, mischief, all right, toil, labor, and that's all this man is about, mischief, It says toil, i.e. it says a wearing effort, hence worry, whether of body or mind. And these people are worried to death, man. People are terrified, man. You know, people don't know, you know, they because all they talk about is death, man. I don't want to die. You know, you gotta, you know, people are dying. You gotta do this to save lives, you know, take the, you know, the thing to save lives. And you see, people are very wearisome, you know, with all these you know, inconvenience, you know, of what they call the pandemic, man. You know, people are being destroyed under these false pretenses, man. You see? Now, let's go from there. It says to trouble a wearisome, a wickedness, man. And this man is his wickedness, all right, is wearing people out, man. You know? So let's go from there. I want to go into all right, because the elites, you know, that's where the commands are coming from, these elites. You see? Hold on. You'll load it. Now, you have a term, all right, from the World Economic Forum, which they have, you know, an agenda by 2030. All right. Now, when you go to what does you will own nothing and be happy mean? Now, it says, you will own nothing and be happy. It said this comes from the World Economic Forum's call for more sustainable circular economy, because they are also incorporating inclusivity, all right, and technology will supposedly, according to them, make almost everything free. The circular, all right, economy extends into the sharing economy. So now, you know, they're pushing the narrative that, all right, they're going to make a lot of things free through their technology. You see, this man is really pushing his technology as some pseudo salvation, you know. And as an Israelite, all right, if you're not rooted in the true salvation that's to come, all right, you'll be caught up in this, man. You'll be wandering after the beast, after his pseudo salvation through his technology, man. You know. So when you I got an article, another article I want to get. All right. All right. Yep. Now this is dealing with mom and pop. All right, landlords. All right, these different landlords who have these different properties, you know, these private owned properties that they are renting and leasing out. You know, they catching the ill, you know. Because when you go on two different blacklistednews.com, it says mom and pop landlords. All right, this the title. All right, mom and pop landlords dying on the vine as unevictable tenants enjoy pandemic protections. You see, so while you have, you know, people, you know, living in these different properties rent free, the landlords are catching hell. You see? This man's, you know, that's why scriptures say the wickedness, all right, of all right, the wisdom, all right, of the wicked is not knowledge, man. All right, because how can you fix a problem and create a problem at the same time? You know, because on the front end, you will look at it like the government really cares about the people. You know, they're, you know, allowing people to stay places rent free. You see, but what about the people that own the property, man? They are responsible for the maintenance and the upkeep. You know, here it is. You're getting, you know, here it is. These tenants are getting, you know, unemployment. They're getting stimulus checks. They're getting, you know, the tax returns. You know, and they chilling. You see, so you'll think, well, this government is doing a terrific job. But wait. There's people suffering on the back end of this, man. You know, showing, man, this man is an unfit ruler, man. He's an unjust ruler, man. This is an unrighteous decree, you know? And it says, mom and pop landlords dying on the vine as unevictable tenants enjoy pandemic protections. It says, as millions of renters across America continue to benefit from sweeping protections against eviction during the pandemic, their landlords haven't been so fortunate. All right. It says, in one example, airport janitor, all right, I'll read this quote. It says, this is according to Bloomberg. It says nearly $47 billion in relief, all right, in rent relief from the Biden administration has been slow to materialize, forcing mom and pop landlords into financial hardship or forced to sell to wealthy investors. And who you think the wealthy investors are, man? The elites, man. You know, they're buying these things up. It might be under another, you know, Edomite's name, but they're buying all these things up, man. That's how they get down, man. They create turmoil and buy everything up, man. They put you in the spot of economic, you know, hardship, and then they come up and buy everything up, man. All right? And it said Bloomberg, perhaps, all right, to invoke sympathy for the landlord's class focus on the impact felt by minority landlords, all right, which is you, Jake, man. All right? Just, hey. The landlord just threw. You see, he says, in one example, airport janitor, all right, Jaquan, all right, Villanueva, which sounds like he might be Northern Kingdom, has had to take out a home equity loan to make ends meet while maintaining a 3-unit rental house in East Boston. One of his tenants is 8 months behind on rent while another, an unemployed restaurant dishwasher, owes him $5,000. So you got just tenants just chilling and the landowners are through. You know? So they're showing you that what's a tech, all right, on ownership, man. So like the World Economic Forum, all right, came up with the quote, said you will own nothing and be happy, man. You see? They want more control. All these things are nothing but, you know, ploys for more control. And I end with this precept here. All right. This is a very, you know, unrighteous, you know, wicked rulership, man. You know, and we pray for this man's overthrow, man. We ain't here to pity-pat with this guy, you know, try to make some type of deal. No, man, we want to overthrow this guy, man. He ain't right, you know. It's Proverbs 22:7. It said, the rich ruleth over the poor, and the borrower is servant to the lender. Yeah, because you got these homeowners having to take out loans, all right, to keep up their properties, all right? And who are they taking loans from, man? It all goes back to the banks. So now you just put yourself in more servitude. You give the bankers more leverage upon you, all right, through these servitude, man. You know, through you borrowing, man. You see? And these people that are just sitting here collecting checks, they're being, all right, they're becoming more and more dependent on who, man? You see? It all goes back to more control and more dependency on the elites, man. So when they come, all right, with their end game, their MOB, all right, the majority of you people will be primed and ready, man. You know? So I just want to put that out there, Lord Willis, edifying, till next time I say Shalom.